贵兄弟姊妹和杂区，欢迎大家来参加灵辉堂中文崇拜会。但咱咧举行第四礼拜的 40 Days in the Word， 来参加看一节的经文，在提摩太后书第二章第十五节，你着出力在上帝的面前，直往希结，做无愧的工人。加多加以分解真理的道。即阵，咱要用诗歌来敬拜咱的上帝，咱要请咱的苦安稳结束。我尊你兄弟，甲咱的四五会会姊妹来大声念诵。
上帝，人为的大恩。
今仔日有艾鲁塞斯班伫遮要特别的节目，叶大友长老要共人牧道。今仔日的经文是伫提摩太后书第二章十四到十五节，要请柯家金兄弟共人读经。
咱来三合祈祷，听阮的阿爸父上帝，阮搁一摆伫啊来到主你的施恩的宝座前，今仔早起，搁一摆来敬拜、来尊崇、来倚靠你。主啊，你是信实的上帝，主啊，你是值得阮敬拜的，值得阮高举的。主啊，阮今仔日啊早起，伫啊为着这乌克兰甲俄罗斯的这个战。带到主你的面前，主啊，阮恳求你，求主你帮助这乌克兰的人民，主特别的信徒，主啊，继续地倚靠你，主啊，你主啊，遮代志，主阮虽然未明白，但是主阮知影讲，主你也可是掌管一切的上帝，主啊，阮活伫一个真正动乱的世界，但是主你也可是阮的避难所。主啊，这个世界的末日也是近了，求主在啊，让阮的重担在你的内面。主啊，求主你加添，主你加你的信心。天父上帝，阮也是继续为着阮的宣教士，在啊 Raymond 甲 Beth Chan 继续祈祷。主啊，因伫IGSL 伫神学教育的工作，主啊特别为 Pastor Raymond 伊伫啊咧准备伊的博士学位的论文。愿主你伫遐，互伊有通专心，通有一个对的动机伫遐来完成一个工作。主，阮也是为着因伫暑假的顶面指导，主因伫遐 IGSL 为着遮学生因伫遐咧继续指导因。愿上帝伫遐用因伫遐来教导，甲伫因家己的生命的顶面伫遐来装备遮学生。主，阮也是继续为伊的家庭。因的灵性，主因家来的关系，主啊求主继续分中进，伫啊面对头前的挑战。听阮的天父，阮也是继续为着教会的事工，伫主的面前伫啊来祈祷，为着一个要来圣周的 Life Camp， 特别在青年的甲儿童的工作，为着因的讲员伫啊来祈祷，主啊阮为着青年的讲员Pastor Jebo Banzuelo。甲青年的遮囡仔儿童的，就是Danny 甲 Michelle Ching 主要你继续互因主你的话语要推，为着阮遮青年人甲囡仔通所得到主你的话。主要阮也是为着教会这个运动 40 Days in the Word 伫遐来祈祷，愿主你的话伫遐继续正做阮脚前的灯，路上的光。主啊，让每一位的兄弟姊妹 底下有一款听主的话，有一款的确定，底下无疑会顺服主的话。做阮过一摆，为着早起的讲完，阮的 Pastor Elmer Huang 底下求主底下鼓舞伊底下准备主的话语，要对阮每一个人底下来讲话。恳求圣灵底下继续刺察阮的心，用主的话，主要阮实在有法通靠着主的底下继续的改变。愿主你继续保守每一个教会的家中大小，搁一摆带到主你的面前。愿主你伫遐怜悯、帮助、照顾。我安尼满心感谢，我落的祈祷，搁一摆是奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名祈求。阿门，阿门。
提摩太后书
第二章十四至十九节，你着托证人回信这代志。在主面前宽恕伊，毋通为着言语争辩，这是无益处的，只会败坏听伊的人。你着出力，在上帝面前得蒙喜悦，做无愧的工人，照正义分解真理的道。但是要完毕世俗的负担，因为这款人的确真高。搁较无精神的地步，因的话如同毒虫，哪乱哪大，其中有苦味乃甲非味道。因偏离了真多，讲过我的代志已经过，就败坏了真侪人的信心。咱是上帝坚固的根基，徛条路，顶面有这印记讲。主明白一罪是伊个人，佮讲凡称呼主名个人，总要离开不义。
今仔日信息题目是：小心讲解真理。咱个讲员是黄督主传道，林玉林长老要共咱翻译，了黄李牧师要共咱祝福。
Good morning, everyone.
We are talking.
As situations in life change,
当咱的生命真侪物件咧改变的时阵
，we get to realize that there are certain things we thought valuable but are not.
有真侪以前咱认为是重要的，现在咱就知影讲无遐尼重要。
There are things that we have taken for granted.
以前咱较疏忽的一寡物件。
But now appreciated their importance for us.
现在咱反正诶感觉讲真重要，咱会较好好地啊来去遵守。
When that happens, we learn to take extra effort to care and value them.
所以咱啊受着这代志呢，咱现在诶较小心也来处理。
So what are the things that we usually handle with care?
什么物件是咱常常会叫做较小心去处理的呢
？They can be valuable items that we use each day.
可能是咱每日在用的一挂较宝贝的器具。
Or things we mark fragile outside the package.
还是有一箱的物件，咱外头有写讲小心，容易破碎。
It can also be personal sentiments or treasure passed on from one generation to the other and to you.
还是咱个人，还是家庭的中间，一代搁传予一代，啊，咱认为是一挂宝贝的物件。
One of my hobbies is coin collection.
啊，我家己有一个代志爱做的呢，就是收藏跩钱币。
Because I was drawn into their design.
因为我真爱因的设计。
So I would place them inside an album to keep them from being scratched.
啊，所以呢，我本呢，将伊收集一切呢，该很可惜。
But I think the more serious collectors would put them in a coin slot instead.
啊，但是万一那是更加详细的捡跩物件的人呢，伊的每一个银币呢，拢会藏伫一个塑胶的袋仔里面。
So I would arrange them either by denomination or by sets if I have a complete one.
所以我会按照着因黑白的价值呢，该排列妥些，还是讲我若有规套的，
Once in a while, it is interesting to see how coins are being auctioned on Facebook.
So, you see, in Facebook, I mean, you can see people who are going to be able to buy it.
An old 1 peso coin can fetch around 4 to 5 digits in value.
So, it's a coin, a quipe, a chicken company, what I'm going to buy, and I'm going to buy.
Of course, I just watched and I did not participate.
我只有看人賣賣，但是我自己沒有做這個生意。
But it's quite tempting to do.
但是真正有引誘我會去愛做這個東西。
But out in the world, some rare ones can go to millions.
但是看到有的國家稀罕的跩軍幣，他們有法通賣甚至幾百萬。
But if one is not careful and damage them,
但是如果不小心去處理，他如果受傷呢？
The quality will be affected. It will lose its value.
它的价值就会减少咯。
And it will not be treasured by anyone anymore.
按你来说，人就不会去收集。
I just saw a funny news that a painting worth $1 million was vandalized by a guard that was supposed to guard it.
最近我有一个真正趣味的一个新闻，就是有一张达美金100万的这个图画呢，原本是给那个故意的这个警卫呢，给毁坏。
But there are also things that we handle with care that are intangible.
咱所要好好处理的物件，有一寡呢，唔是手会通忘掉的物件。Like
a family name，
比如讲咱诶家庭的名声，a
belief，
咱的信用，or
relationship，
还是咱甲人之间诶这个关系。We
thought of times when we can freely hug our families or friends。
所以咱有去珍惜，或时间就是咱往甲咱的家庭做一下。To
go out and eat without being haunted by the virus.
我当时甲出去吃，免惊会去染着这个病毒。And
even coming together to worship and have fellowship with believers is something we have missed for a long time.
我相信咱真侪人呢，也真正怀念，咱已经真久无搁再有法当像是三甲组织来敬拜主。
In that we're able to sing praises to God aloud with the church.
有法当在礼拜堂的内面呢，有法当大声来唱歌赞美主。
And one thing that God wants us to handle with care is it is His word that He has given to us.
有一项上帝要小心去处理的，就是伊所给咱的话语，还是上帝的道。
As God's people, we represent Him.
咱做上帝兄弟，咱也是代表咱的上帝。And
we are not to confuse His truth, but to present it well to others with our life.
所以呢，咱唔通混乱上帝的道，就是借着咱的生命，有法通来表达完全上帝的话语。We
see in Paul's letter to Timothy that he's training Timothy to minister to the church.
原来所看的，我是保罗写给提摩太，未训练伊怎样来牧养伊的教会。And
there are people who are distorting the gospel message or sharing the other kind of message.
咱就发现，迄个时阵呢，有一挂人因传唔对的道理，还是传另外一个福音，which
is causing confusion among the people, and that they must be stopped.
所以呢，在信徒呢。 有时说混乱，保罗认为这个咱就该停止。So
he tasked Timothy to teach the people and bring them back to the main truth, and not to engage in their senseless talk.
所以保罗就教导提摩太，就让跩人呢，因有法当知影迄个真理，啊，袂搁再受混乱。Or
else they will be led astray and be corrupted.
啊，跩人若无该教导呢？ In a Yambelo.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 14 says, remind them of these things and charge them before God not to quarrel about words, which does no good, but only ruins the hearer.
所以提摩太后书第二章十四节，保罗安尼讲，你就和众人回想跩代志，以主的面前来欢呼因，唔通为言语争辩，这是无益处的，只会败坏听见的人。
So Paul wants to remind the church before God to be careful in what they say.
所以保罗呢就提醒当时的教会，以主的面前对因所传讲的物件就真正细腻。
As God's children, we live by the truth that God has given us.
咱做上帝的儿女，咱是按照上帝的真理来生活。
And in that time, they are taught by the apostles or through the book of law.
早期的教会，因是有使徒底下来教导因，还是亲像保罗安尼款的人来教导因。
Aside from that, they are not to dwell on false teaching.
因唔通底下来听怀唔对，还是误解的教导。
Paul wants Timothy to remind them and charge them before God.
所以保罗呢叫提摩太要提醒跩信徒。
As this is very important matter.
因为这个是真正重要的代志。
For once the truth is altered, it will cause others to fall or be confused.
因为这个真理呢，那是受改变呢，人呢就会跌倒，会真侪无好的代志发生。
Same thing applies to us. We should be careful in what we say.
上关今仔日也着真正细腻，讲到咱所讲的，还是咱所教导的。
For it is easy for people to twist certain truths and deceive us that it comes from God.
因为真常呢，在家教书呢，有发当真容易来传讲，我咱认为这个是上帝的话。
One example we might think that it's from the Bible is like this phrase: "Money is the root of all evil."
比如讲，一个人那说金钱是万恶之根。
If this is the case, then none of us should ever keep money, or I wouldn't have my own coin collection.
假如那是按咱凊彩人就无需要捡钱，还是亲像我无咧捡怀银币。
First Timothy 6:10 says, "For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil."
但是提摩太前书六章十节其实是按伊讲贪财。这是万恶之根。
So there's a difference there. Money in itself is not evil, but the love of it is.
所以这呢，两句话有真细，但是真不是意思差别真大的，就是唔是讲钱是万恶之根，乃是讲贪财这是万恶之根。
So Timothy is to remind them that they are under God who is true.
所以这呢，提摩太提醒因。要知影，因是伫上帝的主管的下面。
The church is to be careful in what they say or believe in.
所以教会本身就真正细腻伫因所传讲的。
For they stand before God and in His law.
因为因是徛伫上帝的道的面前。
We are to abide in His ways and not be involved in falsehood.
咱应该就按照着伊话语来生活行做。唔通伫遐来传讲跩唔对嘅道理。
The church is not to be the source of disagreements or the cause of division among people.
教会本身呢，也唔通伫遐来引起真侪嘅争论，还是讲互真侪人会作无好好。
It is where truth is to be found.
教会内面应该是真理会通伫遐找着嘅所在。
Instead of those controversies, they are to speak about the testimony of the Lord, the gospel, and about the faithfulness of Jesus.
所以你应该就传讲的关于主耶稣的代志，甲伊的信息，唔是要去传讲怀争论的代志。
So Timothy is also to warn them against unprofitable arguments.
提摩太呢，也是保罗的教导呢，就是唔通就对人。来宽勉，可以唔通去为跩无路用嘅代志来争论。
While we cannot avoid having misunderstanding or differences of preferences from one another,
虽然咱无法避免共识，但彼此之间有时有无同的看法。
There's nothing wrong to have an honest inquiry from one another and from the teachers.
所以呢，咱啊，黄泽先生，也是咱彼此之间有一个叫做真诚的沟通。
In fact, that's how we learn from one another, and that's also what keeps the fellowship united.
啊，这个是好的，咱就是安尼来学习，也是让咱彼此有好的团结。
Acts chapter 2 verse 42 says, And they devoted themselves to the apostles' teachings and the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers.
所以我们在这个《使徒行传》第二章四十二节有看到初期的教会，他们都专心致意在这个使徒的教导，并且他们有很好的团结。
But when the discussion is driving people towards falsehood, then that becomes dangerous.
所以怀疑那无需要的辩论呢，啊是真正危险，会让人行入另外唔对的道路。
It has nothing good to offer. They are in a way useless conversations, for it will lead to quarrel.
啊，所以呢，无妨带来什么好处？所以争论呢，只不过啊，其实是会败坏人诶。
They may come in a forms like debate or arguments, which has a negative connotation.
所以欠债是会引起呢人个怀争辩，还是辩论，啊，跩拢是较负面的物件。
Even if we say debates can be neutral, there's a high tendency that the talks will heat up, which will end up in tension from each other.
虽然咱有时是中立的，但是真侪时阵经过这个争论还是争辩呢，啊，咱的关系呢所受破坏。
Not only that, it will ruin those who hear it.
不断做安尼，怀听的人，因也是不断那无得到造就，反等呢被毁坏。
Their faith will be affected, and their impression from one another can be ruined. That will sever their relationship also.
因的信心会受摇动，并且因的个人的关系也是会受影响。
But if the talk is done with respect to God's truth,then they can have a more meaningful discussion and exchange of ideas.
但是咱是以上帝的话语做咱的中心来讲呢，咱的跩讨论呢，就会带来正面的好处。
So it's almost election time, and we have several candidates to choose from to take the position as the president of our country if they are elected.
咱无论要有这个菲律宾的这个大选。有真侪人啊，要伫遐来竞选做菲律宾诶总统。
There are posts saying that their friendship broke up just because they do not have the same candidate in mind.
有真侪人呢，因为因爱选诶对象无同呢，因煞毋是好朋友咯。
There are Christian leaders who would mark candidates as evil, and those who will vote for him or her is also evil.
跩诶，教会领袖呢，伊会讲某某诶，这个竞选者呢，伊是伊无好诶，是恶诶，是歹诶，所以反正选伊诶人也是歹诶。
Then there's this vaccination issues, and again, people fight over these things.
然后呢，咱啊提高这个叫做要去签疫苗诶代志呢，有诶人啊无相关诶意见，所以也是带来真侪纷争。
Which can destroy one another in the end.
所以到结果呢，人的关系呢也算受破坏。
True enough, in every situation, there are issues that may be contradicting to God's truth.
真侪在要注意的代志呢，因甲上帝的真理呢是相对的。
That's why we need to carefully handle it, so we will have a clear view of things.
所以咱就真正细腻地啊来讲解，还是理解，那无会产生无好的结果。
And the way we resolve them should not be based on hearsay, emotions, and sentiments or such, but instead to be done in light of the truth of our God.
所以咱就用上帝的真理呢来处理跩代志，唔是凭着咱的感觉，还是咱的感情也来处理。
For we have to present ourselves to God.Faithful in his truth.
是讲咱每一个人 我哋上帝面前啊，来做一个忠心啊，分辨真道的人。
Verse 15 says, "Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly handling the word of truth."
所以提摩太后书二章十五节是安尼讲，恁着竭力伫上帝面前得蒙喜悦，做袂无愧的工人，按着正义来分解真理的道。
As God's people, we live in the truth, and that truth is found in His Word.
咱做上帝子民，啊，咱就活伫伊的真理的内面，这个真理会通伫上帝的话语内面通找着。
And His words contain all we need for us to live godly life.
上帝话语呢，也是有教义，予咱啊知影所有的原则，还是真理。我当活出一个敬畏上帝的生活。
Paul mentioned before to Timothy, in 1 Timothy 4:8, that godliness is of value in every way, as it holds promise for the present life and also for the life to come.
保罗在提摩太前书也有提到讲，啊，这个上帝的话语里面呢，有真宝贵的应允，唔单单是来生，一直到今生呢。
Then in later part, in his final charge, he said that all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness.
In 提摩太后书三章呢，伊又提到啊，上帝的话语啊，拢是上帝所启示的、所默示的，以教训、督责、予人规正、教导人合宜，拢是有益处的。
Meaning we do not live two separate lives, one for the world and one for the spiritual.
啊，这个也是跟咱讲，咱未做有叫做两款的生活方式，一个是为世界活，一个是叫做为主来活。
But whether we serve God in the church or work in business or enjoy our family time, we present ourselves to God in righteousness.
所以无论咱是教会内面的侍奉。啊，是伫咱的工作的工场顶，啊，是咱甲咱的家庭做一个时阵，咱拢伫主的面前呢，啊，应该伫活伫伊的真理的内面。
The way we live our life reveals what we believe in。
所以咱怎样伫来活出呢？这个也是会反映咱信什么。
And from that, people who see us will usually associate us to something or to someone。
所以对咱的生活，人就会将咱甲上一款、上一类的人家分辨做一个。
Now that shopping has mostly gone online thanks to our COVID situation,
咱因为这个疫情的缘故呢，所以真侪时阵咱买物件拢是伫网顶咧买。
We heard of many complaints regarding how their items are being mishandled by the company.
啊，咱也是常常会听到真侪人因发怨言呢，就是因买物件呢，啊，就是无好好来处理。
They are either damaged, half open, or incomplete.
有时你收到这物件已经有损坏，还是讲有人家偷窥了。
We also see videos of how the workers would just throw at a package instead of properly placing them in front of the door of its destination.
咱应该也捌看到一款的视频呢，就是看到跩咧交货的人，因就是将个蛋去，无好好的给放伫你的门口。
We can liken that to how we handle God's word in our life.
咱用这个来当譬如讲，咱有时咱怎样的呀来处理上帝的话语。
We are God's representative.
咱是上帝的代表。
And it is possible that we mishandle his words too, that the hearers hear lies instead of truth.
所以咱咧传讲的，有时咱也无细腻，可能咱会传讲唔对的物件，会败坏迄个听的人。
We at times share just half of the truth so as not to offend others, because we think that truth can hurt, but we know that truth also sets one free.
啊，有时呢，咱为着袂去伤着别人呢，咱只有讲一半的真理。啊，这个其实是也是唔对的。
or we just throw it out to them, hoping they will be able to pick it up on their own and assemble them afterwards.
有时可能咧，想辨别，咱就是种在多啲单货因，唔忙讲因自己去处理，系处理何适因嘅辨别。
Or maybe because we ourselves have not fully understood the value and beauty of God's word, that's why we become careless and indifferent towards His truth.
啊，是讲咱自己完全辨别上帝嘅真理呢？所以连咱咧处理上帝嘅真理，还是传讲嘅时阵，咱就真正无小心。
Just like the one who delivers a package，
亲像话咧，送喜帖嘅人。
Like it or not, he is in a way a representative of the company.
无论怎样，伊就是代表伊所咧做工嘅一个公司。
If he did a good job, then the company is praised. But if he did a bad one, then there would be a bad review or a complaint directed to the company.
所以因啊，最好些呢，这个公司会通得到人的称赞啊。最不好些，人会底下来埋怨，还是投诉。
As God's child, we represent God, and we must do our best to present ourselves as one approved by God.
所以咱做上帝，今日咱就接纳。来叫做最主底下所认定的工人。
We have heard of people saying that they don't read the Bible, but they look at the believer's life as their Bible, as the Bible.
啊，咱不听有人讲，自己本身无读圣经，但是伊就是看为信徒的生活当作伊的圣经。
In a sense, through our testimony, they sort of get to read the Bible.
是的，咱会叫做见证呢，是人所要读的这个圣经。
But if our life does not represent God well, then that would make them stumble.
所以咱的生命，若无好好来表达上帝呢，咱会叫人跌倒。
And God warns us against that, saying, "But take care that this right of yours does not somehow become a stumbling block to the weak."
所以圣经里面也是经过咱啊，咱就随地贬低咱正做别人的绊脚石。
So how do we actually present ourselves approved by God？
所以咱要怎啊底下呢活出这个款的生活，会互人看出咱是上帝所已经验证合适的人呢
？By being a person who handles His truth carefully and with great understanding。
啊，就是咱对上帝的真理。咱有好好的理解并且传讲。
Second Timothy chapter 2 verse 21 says, "Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from what is dishonorable, he will be a vessel for honorable use, set apart as holy, useful to the master of the house, ready for every good work."
我咧有说21节啊，你讲人若自觉脱离卑贱的代志，就得各做贵重的器皿。正做圣洁，合乎主用，务必行各款的善事。
We set ourselves for honorable use。
咱应该着立志爱做上帝贵重的用处。
We will prepare ourselves to keep away from filthy things。
所以咱着备办，那是装备家己啊，无去行坏、秘密，还是污秽的代志。
We will fix our minds.In Him, ready to follow Him.
所以咱的思想拢是伫啊立志要来跟随伊。
To go wherever He wants us to go, we become ready to do His will.
所以要去上帝爱咱去的所在，咱定定是陪伴好些，要做上帝爱咱做的代志。
And one way of knowing what His will is to study His word carefully.
所以咱若要怎啊知影上帝的旨意呢？就是要小心好好来研读上帝的圣经
，so that we will not misinterpret His word, lest we do what is contrary to what He wants。
然后，咱袂去误解圣经的话语，咱就按真理来行。
Once or twice a year, we have our aircon cleaned by our contact。
啊，一年内面呢，像咱这个冷气机会叫人来改净水。
And we haven't called them for a while.
但是最近咱阮真久无阁叫因来清理。
One day our doorbell rang and I went to open the door to find two guys ready to clean our aircon.
有一日呢，我听到阮的门铃咧等伊，我开门的时阵就是两个人要来甲阮洗这个冷气机。
But we were confused since we didn't call them.
但是阮真正惊奇，因为阮无叫伊。
So I asked my brother, who usually is the one who contact them, and asked him if he told them to come.
所以我就问我的阿兄，有替阮叫这个清理的人还是无？
And then my brother said that they are supposed to clean the aircon, but not in our house in Manila, but in a school in Valenzuela.
但是伊叫跩人呢，是要来咱的牧师的厝内呢，乃是要去神学院遐给因洗冷气。
So these guys got the wrong address and have to travel a long distance again.
所以这两个人呢，因找唔到诶这个地址呢，所以因就过。
They got the right tools, the right mission, but in the wrong place.
虽然因带来工具跩拢是对的，但是因去的所在是唔对的。
Hopefully that would not happen to us as we follow God's instruction.
我望讲咱咧遵守上帝诶带领的时阵，咱袂有安尼款唔对的代志发生。
To help us know His ways, we should diligently learn to understand His words.And thoughts, then follow them.
So, if we want to know God's way, we also need to diligently learn God's way.
There are many ways to learn them.
There are many ways to learn God's way.
And if you have the workbook by Rick Warren, you can find his 12 ways of studying the Bible.
If we have read Rick Warren's book, he has told us about 12 steps.
But for today, I want to categorize it differently for us all.
但是今仔日呢，我用另外一个方式呢，以下个简洁来讲。
So there are 4 categories.
有四个层面。
But they're all the same. Studying the Bible.
这四个拢是关系到读圣经的代志。
So I separated for the businessman.The students, the geeks, or the artists.
So, you are the best. You are the best student, or the other people.
If you want to study with the big picture, you can do these 3 things.
So, for example, you know this Bible's great scale, you can do 3 things.
You can read it chronologically.
You can do it according to the events that happened in the past.
Yeah, where you base on the flow of the history.
So this is 按照着以迄个发生诶日子啊，底下来读。
Study by book of the Bible.
还是咱是按每一卷诶圣经来读。
Before you go to the other books of the Bible.
所以咱是每一卷好好读了，再去读另外一卷。
Or through cross reference, where you look at the footnotes and.See how they are interconnected to each other.
还是有法当用这个串珠和相似的跩经文呢，有法当连接做一下。
Or for students who might want a little bit more details, they can study it by chapter, following the breaks of each topic. Or yeah.
那最后，伊爱靠读较详细哩，伊有法当读每一章，然后看。即每一章呢，分做几个段落
，or by verse, where you can paraphrase or the verse into your own words.
还是甚至是叫做每一节好好来读，然后用你家己的话语呢，搁一摆重新来表达。
Or by character study, like a biography, study the life of each character mentioned in the Bible.
还是咱有法当用这个人物的研究来读圣经。就是研究圣经里面每一个无常的人物。
Or for the geeks who wants to be technical in things, they can do a word study, reading certain words, how it is used, if there are any cultural meaning compared to today's usage.
还是外国靠这款电脑这个技巧的人呢，现在因爱安尼读圣经，就是叫做。在重要的研究。
Or they can also do the original language by studying the Hebrew and Greek language.
还是国家中西人又爱来研究圣经以伯来文的古约，还是新约的希腊文。
Or through historical facts, ancient text discovery, manuscripts, science or evidences.
还是咱当研究甲圣经相关的。在叫做考古的物件，还是在科学的物件。
And the last one, artists, for me is just a way to relax as you study.
但最后一项，较有艺术的人，你读圣经呢，是较咱一款让你休息的方法。
Like through reflections or devotional style, to be thoughtful and actually see.Actual examples of people and situation.
咱有法通来默想，来思想咱所读的圣经，还是与相关的人物。
Or you can do it creatively, especially in its application, using your talents, to apply what you have learned. You can do it.
重要的，就是咱要应用的时阵，咱有法通用咱的这个创意力呢，底下来，我要怎样？来应用上帝的话语。
You can make the God's word into a painting, a picture, or music, or a poem.
你望将这段的圣经，甘再用一首的诗来表达出来，还是画一张的图，安尼款来表达
？Or simply listen to an audio Bible, and as you listen, you imagine how it goes.
还是咱来听。或叫做录音的圣经，咱一边听一边来想象上帝的话语咧讲什么。
There's really no need for categories. Anyone can use this method as they see fit.
Actually, 是讲呢，咱每个人有法当用在无同的方式底下来读圣经。
With so many ways to learn God's word, there's so much more treasure we can discover in Him.
有真多方式来读圣经，有法通去挖掘也掘更加多的宝贝的物件。
May we present ourselves faithful to God, whom He can trust and depend on, rightly handling His word of truth.
对，咱对上帝，信实的上帝，咱要忠心，咱也要按照着正义底下来分解主的道。
But we don't end here. There is also a need for us to.Handle those who swerve from faith carefully.
So we also need to continue using faith, using caution to handle God's word.
Even hazardous materials should be handled with care.
We know that some dangerous things still need to be very carefully handled.
At home, we store carefully the cleaning materials like the toilet bowl cleaner, rat poisons, thinners.And many more.
比如讲，伫厝内呢，咱有跩咧洗那个洗好清洁的跩物件，啊是怀咧廿多支的物件，咱要真正洗滴来处理。
Because if we do not handle them properly, it can cause trauma, burns, illness, and even death.
因为咱若无小心处理呢，有可能会带来真侪无好。结果，比如讲，咱去惊到，还是讲有啥物损坏。
These erring people can be hazardous to our faith as also.
所以，在那讲解唔对的人呢，因对咱来讲呢，也是会带来灾害。
Or they will lead people to sin.
还是因会带人去犯罪。
As mentioned, we know that the Bible is used for correction.
咱知影圣经。也是有法通来指责教导人
，and that's what most countries are doing, including ours.
真侪时阵呢，来借着一个艺术，也是有法通来表达这款的物件。
Sadly, in Illinois, it's illegal to read the Bible in public schools.
现在伫美国的伊利诺伊呢，袂做伫叫做公共的所在来读圣经。
But a law requires the state to provide a Bible for every convict.
但是呢，因却有一个条规呢，是讲，予怀入去关的人，大家人就有一本圣经。
But irony. So if the kid's life gets into trouble because they are deprived from the Bible, how come they will use the Bible to correct them when they are already in prison?
这个看来是一个很大的矛盾，就是说做孩子的人他不做公开读圣经，等他读到问题去关他了，然后你才要叫他读圣经。
Verse 16 says, but avoid irreverent babble, for it will lead people into more and more ungodliness.
在这第16节是跟我们说我们要避免坏负担的东西，因为这个是让人更加无敬虔。
Check the words irreverent and ungodliness.
所以这是讲叫做无敬虔的对步。
There are people who are disrespectful, wicked, or heathenish.
所以有一群人，因就是未尊重别人，就是按呢款的无敬。
Which will lead them to not wanting to know God or become godless. So they have to be corrected. We need to correct them because their lives will quickly corrupt others.
So we need to correct them because their lives will quickly corrupt others. Like a disease, it can quickly affect others. Those who are weak will stumble and doubt God.
So if they are
weak, they will
doubt their
ability to
God. They too become irreverent or ungodly.
So they will become irreverent or ungodly.
Living life without God in the mind but themselves.
So in their life, they will not have God in their mind.
That's why Paul continued in verses 23 to 26, telling Timothy what he can do with regards to these people.
所以你第23节到26节，保罗教导提摩太要怎样来面对这款的人。
Verse is found in 2 Timothy 2, verses 23 to 24, says, "Have nothing to do with foolish, ignorant controversies. You know that they breed quarrels, and the Lord's servant must not be quarrelsome, but kind to everyone, able to teach patiently, enduring evil."
提摩太又像二十三节、十四节，独独怀愚拙无学问的辩论，总着气绝。因为知影跩代志是起正经的，连你呢主的仆人唔通正经，是要温温和和的来待对待正人，善于教导，存心吞论。
He tells them or him not to join in their senseless talk.
而且保罗。咱就分别跩人，唔通参与伫跩无意思的争论。
The following verses 25 to 26 says, correcting his opponents with gentleness, God may perhaps grant them repentance leading to a knowledge of truth, and they may come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil after being captured by him to do his will.
所以这个在国际上讲，用温柔。劝戒怀疑等的人，或者上帝和因悔改的心，通明白真道，叫因这已经和魔鬼临伊掠去的，会通醒悟脱离伊的网罗。
If they would listen, they can be corrected.
因若愿意听，因就发通被改正。
With the hope that they will repent, recover to sound mind, and be freed from their evil mind.
希望因会通伫遐悔改。
In the end, the reason why we are to handle God's word with care in relation to God's people is because for the fact that we are God's people.
最后呢，就是咱就好好按照着正义来处理上帝话语呢，是因为咱是上帝的子民。
We do not belong to the prince of this world.
So we are not from this world and this world.
Verse 19 says, but God's firm foundation stands bearing this seal. The Lord knows those who are his, and that everyone who names the name of the Lord depart from iniquity.
Okay.
So we are to handle ourselves with care since we are God's people.
所以咱本身呢，咱的生活，咱也要真正随地的来处理，因为咱是上帝的子民。
God knows those who are His.
上帝知影谁啊是属伊的。
And His people call unto Him and not to the devil.
所以跩人呢是求告上帝，唔是求告迄个恶者。
As we have been following Jesus, we know that Jesus does only what He saw His Father is doing.
所以咱若跟底下做，咱会知影。伊只有做按照天父所要做的代志。
For the Father shows him what he does.
因为天父呢，伊来显明伊所做的代志。
And also Jesus showed it to us.
耶稣相关也是用咱来显明。
God knows his people.
上帝认捌伊的百姓。
And that also means that he knows those who are not his.
所以这个也表示说，我们不属于他，他也知道是多少人。
So we should be careful how we present ourselves to him.
所以我们就真正随地要怎样站在上帝的面前。
In reality, we can't deceive him though.
看起来我们就真像刚才有法当骗上帝。
No matter how we try to act righteously, he knows.
我们刚才外表看起来我们最真多对的代志。
The truth will come out whether or not we are His.
但是有一日呢，咱是不是想谁是属于伊的，一个真理会出来。
And it is seen in the fruit that we produce.
这个呢，就是要对咱的生命里面所发出的果子来看。
If we constantly produce bad fruit, then we may have to reevaluate our relationship with Him.
所以呢，咱若是常常接歹计、接歹计之呢，咱就省察咱家己是毋是真实属于上帝。
As His people, our lips are made to worship Him, to praise Him, and glorify Him.
所以咱做上帝的主民呢，上帝给咱这个嘴呢，也是要底下来阿罗伊的目标。
James 3:9-10 says that we can't combine blessings and cursing together.
所以圣经又甲咱讲，咱袂用上一支嘴。阿罗上帝上一支嘴，我哋也来救助人。
It says, "With it we bless our Lord and Father, and with it we curse people who are made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come blessing and cursing. My brothers, these things ought not to be."
所以这个提醒咱，咱若是安尼做，这个是唔应该，因为咱的嘴呢就是要单单地也来阿罗上帝。
Our life belongs to God, and we present Him in this world.
咱的生命也是属于咱的主，咱伫这个世界也是代表咱的主。
We are His light, so that others can see Him.
咱是伊的，对这个角度来讲，咱是伊的光，借着咱人会通认捌上帝。
If we are not careful, we will not be able to shine His light effectively, and the lost will be all the more confused as to what.
That
truth really is. And we also want to present ourselves brightly before Him, so we should avoid anything that may stain us or damage us. To do that, we keep ourselves in check through His truth.
所以我们按照着祂的真理常常来省察自己。
Reflecting and growing in Him each day of our life.
是咱每日的生活里面来默想祂。
Studying His truth and living it out in life.
所以要研究祂的道，也是要应用祂的道在咱的生活中。
So we, the church, represent God.
所以咱做教会，咱代表上帝。
So we should be careful in what we say.
咱也着为着咱所讲的物件，着真正随意。
Especially when we get into heated arguments that are not helpful or contributing to the faith.
特别咱有时呐，卷入伫一个争论的中间，其实是无带来什么好处的。
We should avoid such quarrels, but can bring each conversation before God.
咱就避免跩争论， 咱为古所讲的话，就带到伫主的面前。
Knowing that our words has effect on people, and it will also reflect God whom we believe in.
因为咱知影咱的话会去影响别人，那只要反映上帝本身。
Because we represent God, we are to handle His truth carefully.
因为咱是代表上帝，所以伊的真理咱就小心处理。
And His truth should be the core of our life.
伊的真理也应该成为咱生命的核心。
So we should understand what is in His heart by carefully studying His word.
所以咱应该就好好来查考伊的话语，再知影上帝的心意是甚物。
If there are people who have swerved from the faith, we can use God's truth to help correct them and lead them back to God.
有人离开上帝，咱要用上帝的道帮助伊搁行倒转来。
Let us handle with care what God has given us.
所以上帝所交付咱的，咱就小心处理。
And may our life show a reflection of God when we encounter others.
有五百公咱甲人交接的时阵。咱的生命呢，有法通反映上帝。
So that we may lead them to Him through the truth that He has given us.
我咱要放引出怀人呢，来归向上帝所交托咱的真理。
咱这是来接受主的祝福，愿主耶稣基督的恩惠、天父上帝的听堂、圣灵保惠师的感动，甲咱每一位三合一嘞。对今时直到永永远远，阿门。
生命令我们赐福于